So the other reaction I want to show you is the anti-Markovnikov hydrohalogenation. So remember when we were looking at addition reactions, we were looking at a hydrohalogenation and we were understanding that that was a regio-specific reaction. Regio-specific meaning that the halogen would always go to the more substituted of the two carbons participating in the pi bond because of the fact that it would only go by the more stable carbocation intermediate. Remember, this pi bond would get the proton, leave the secondary carbocation, then that's where the bromide would go, and we'd get the Markovnikov product in a regio-specific manner. But then, we didn't look at the mechanism, but we also noted the fact that in the presence of peroxides, this would shift to anti-Markovnikov regiospecificity. In other words, we would get the halogen on the less substituted of the two carbons participating in the pi bond. And we didn't look at why. Well, here's why. It's a free radical reaction. And so the peroxides obviously play a very key role in this. So let's take a look. The initiation step is going to be provided by the peroxides. And so remember when we talked about oxygen-oxygen covalent bonds as ones that are able to undergo homolytic bond cleavage, that's the initiation step. So we have this oxygen-oxygen covalent bond undergoing homolysis, and then we get two hydroxyl radicals. So it's those hydroxyl radicals that are going to propagate the formation of other radicals. So let's say that a hydroxyl radical finds one of these molecules of HBr. Well, what's going to happen is this radical and then one electron from this covalent bond are going to form a new one, and now we've got a water molecule, and then that's going to propagate the existence of a bromine radical. Okay, then from there, this is the key step because this is where the regiospecificity is involved. The bromine radical is going to interact with this pi bond that is necessary for the addition reaction. And what's going to happen is it's going to form a new carbon-bromine bond, but it is going to do it in regiospecific manner because of the stability of the alkyl radical that it will generate. So in other words, one of these pi electrons is going to go to form a covalent bond with this bromine radical, and it is only going to happen here because if it does so, then the other pi electron will go to this carbon, the secondary carbon, leaving the more stable of the two possible alkyl radical intermediates. If the bromine radical interacted at this position and this pi electron went to form the new carbon-bromine bond there, then that would mean that the other pi electron would be left on the primary carbon, and we'd then have a primary alkyl radical intermediate. And that is the less stable of the two, so it will not produce that. So in a regio-specific manner, the bromine will add to the less substituted of the two carbons participating in the pi bond. That leaves a radical, an alkyl radical intermediate, which will then go ahead and undergo another step with HBr, and it will just extract a proton there, leaving another bromine radical there. Recall once again that these are all single-headed electron-pushing arrows denoting the movement of a singular electron. And so we've gotten to our product here. This is our anti-Markovnikov hydrohalogenation product, regio-specific to be the less substituted alkyl bromide of the two possibilities. And we've managed to do it all with propagation steps. There could be termination steps. Choose anything, this radical, the bromine radical, hydroxyl radical, anything. If two radical species meet, they'll terminate, but none of them were needed in the mechanism generating the product, so we didn't draw them. So once again, hydroxyl radical initiates, propagates the existence of the bromine radical, and then the bromine radical goes and goes ahead and adds in regio-specific manner, specifically in an anti-Markovnikov manner, so that it generates the more stable of the possible alkyl radical intermediates. So that will shed some light on the mystery. We understood the mechanism before for the Markovnikov hydrohalogenation, and now we know the mechanism for the anti-Markovnikov variety as well. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me with questions, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.